Matinja Municipal Council.
Actually, I was discussing with him the state of our roads. Because that falls within his mandate. I want to introduce our colleague, Lieutenant Anton Basakana, who is with us.
Basakana.
My brother Louis, who has moved with the entry of
Louis.
My brother John Senyoni, the spokesperson of People Power Movement. My brother and comrade in the struggle, Honorable Zach Francis from
the
He's a survivor of Arua. We are on the church, some church with me and our brother Robert Chagulanyi. Of course, General Bishamont is known to you, he's here with us. My brother Robert Chagulanyi.
Muganda wange Robert Chagulanyi.
And your entrance?
Ne bango bodi nabo.
You are welcome.
Tumanirisa.
In the interest of time,
I want
that some teacher to invite my brother Robert Chagulanyi.
Njagala kutwala omukisa guno okwaniriza muganda wange Robert Chagulanyi.
To speak to our people.
Okwogereri abantu baffe.
Because I know he's moving for the better, and for me, I'm still here with you. I'll make my speech later.
Kubanga mahi alina kufuna njumura wa kigeto kora atenze ganchari wanonja kuwa kogera kwa angenda.
Honorable Robert Chagulanyi.
Uganda. OHTwa Robert Chagulanyi Center.
God is good all the time. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that God is good, brothers and sisters. God is good. And all the time, I'm very, very humbled to be here today. I want to give my special thanks to Pastor Mwanguzi for the invitation. And I want to thank Pastor Drinkard for the amazing words you've got today. It's not an ordinary day today, ladies and gentlemen. Like Pastor Mwanguzi explained, I was supposed to be here with you, celebrating and enjoying the love and fellowship of God with you. But we are only human beings. While we plan, the Almighty makes the grand plan. We were planning to share so many words with you, ladies and gentlemen. But like I told you, one of our comrades lost a father and we have to go to Butambala for burial. We are supposed to be sad for that. But we thank God still. Because our human eye only sees the negative. But God's plan is always a better plan. So much as I will not be able to say all that I wanted to say today, at least I will get a few minutes to share a word with you, and at the same time use this unfortunate opportunity to also say a word to the people of
Butambala.
When Pastor Drinkard was preaching, it was like he was talking about my life. I was looking at a soldier, because soldiers mainly their job is to fight, and military fighting includes death and killing. But here I was looking at an ex-soldier preaching the word of God to us. It communicated to me personally. Because, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not the most qualified person to be talking to you in the presence of God. I am but just a ghetto child. But ultimately, God pointed out reason for my life, and that is why I am standing before you and will be standing before so many people to communicate what I believe God wants them to hear. So this morning I'll talk about only three things, and I'll have the confidence to say the things I'm going to say because I am in the house of God. I am in my Father's house. And when I'm in my Father's house, I don't fear no evil. Ladies and gentlemen, we must be alive to where we are today. Back in the days, communication and guidance to God's people came through the prophets and the preachers of the Holy Word. And we know right from the words, right from the days of Jesus, that we had great, great kings that had superpower. When reading the Bible, I'm not an expert in the Bible, but a few stories that inspired me from the Holy Book. I read about a great king called Pharaoh in Egypt. No matter what he did to show his power and exert his power on the people of God, on the children of God, ultimately the power of God took precedence. Through the men and women of God that stood by God's will, there was a king called Nebuchadnezzar, who everybody was